Let's go back to our eclipse. We can see the count here. Yes, number of rows are 17. Look here. Totally there are 17 rows present in that table. Okay. This is how we grab the information. Now, I'll make one more logic here. Yeah. For I need to find the columns in now my test case. The next test case is I want to find the number of columns present in each row. Okay, so I'll write one for loop. Each column, iterate to each column. Oh, sorry. This is the enhanced for loop. It's nothing. Total, there are total number of rows are 17, right? So I'm telling each iterate, this is like I. For I is equal to 0 till I 17, it will iterate. Return type of I is web element. Okay. You can write normally also. For as we can see previous classes. For I is equal to 0, I less than number of rows, I plus plus. Okay. But I there is web element, not integer. Anything you can write, that's not a problem. Okay, now we'll do one thing. Each row, this is I, that means firstly it goes in first loop. I total there are 17, so from 1 to 17 it will traverse, right? So when the loop goes first time, the first row will traverse go inside. So I'll write each row, I mean first row dot find elements by dot tag name. Now td. And each column will write right by dot tag name. Okay, see what I have done here. So I starts from the 1 to 17. When it goes down for first row dot find elements by dot tag name td. That means have, if you see the notepad, I have told you td under tr. If in each under each row we will see multiple tds, that's nothing but multiple columns in each row. That's what I was interested. So whenever the loop iterates every time, for first time, for first row go and find elements, how many elements are present with tag name td, and throw here. Okay, for second row again print. Again the loop will second row. Again second row dot find elements by dot tag name td. So it will give the count of second row. Like that. Okay. Print. Number of columns in each. Okay. In. We'll do one thing. I'll initialize I here, int I equal to some 0. Okay, so I plus plus. So I'll tell you what I'm doing here. So I'll tell number of columns in I throw. Or each column dot size. Remember, if you use again each column, then it will throw error. We need to give each column dot size. here. Need to concatenate, right? Okay, see here, it's very simple. Whenever it takes the row, each row, it will find how many TDs are there. That means how many columns are there. Okay, so we will get here each column, I mean each row columns will get here. That's what I'm printing here, number of columns in. So I starts from 0. Okay, you will get confused. Let me remove this. Number of columns in each row means in what row. This is nothing but number. This is first row means number of columns in that particular number rows are these many. Okay, like that we will see. Now I'll run this program and I'll let you explain you again. It's very easy. So only one logic you remember: T for rows, TD for columns. So find the table and then use the table dot find elements with TR. You will get total number of rows. Now keep it in a loop till the row size, and each row you just find given element like find elements by dot tag name TD. So you will get each column in that particular row. It's still loading. We can stop it also. Yeah, let it. Okay, it's done. If you see, go back. Some mistake happened. Number of columns. Columns. This is what ending tag name TR. Okay. Okay, when loop is going inside for first time, okay. I'll initialize I to know the which row how many columns is there. I am writing some customized code. Okay, I'll give like this. So first time when it entered, I will be 0. So first time when it entered, I will increment. That means it is in first row. Number of columns in ith row. Okay, this is what before I tried to explain. Right, in the first, it will give like this. Number of columns in first row are these many. Again, loop traverse. I should give this outside. Okay, now for first time it will go inside, so it will print like this. Number of columns in first row are these many. Okay, when the loop runs for second time, it will increment, and number of columns in second row are these many, third row like this, so that user friendly. That's what I tried to write before. I took one more variable and I'm using this for a clear debug file. By now you should be able to understand the things, because these all are some advanced things, okay, like which involved a core Java, like keeping it in a loop and all. I guess it's done. No, it's still loading. Net connection was slow actually. Let me stop. I think it's enough. Stop. Okay, and see here. This how the debug was very clear now. Total rows are 17 and number of columns in row 1 are 8, row 2 are 8, row 3 are 9. row 4 are 2. See, this is how you got a complete picture, like how many rows are there total and how many columns are there in each row. So many pages got opened, right? Let me close one by one. Okay, now let it be there. If you are interested, so simple logic I have written. I found total number of rows, and for each row I kept iteration. In each row, when the loop end inside first particular row, that particular row dot find elements with tag name td. In that row, go and find elements with tag name td. That means find the columns. I have thrown it into this variable. I am giving dot size. That means number of columns in that particular row we can see. Now, if you are interested to grab the text which is present in that table, okay, in the same for loop, I'll write one more for loop. This is for grabbing the text, and this is for finding columns. Then column count in each row. Finding cell value, what text is present in the particular value. It's very simple again. So what I'll do is, and now observe clearly. Okay, text, each column I know count, right? So in first row these many column, see, in the first row when I took by dot tag name td, all the columns have came into this each column variable. So if you want to size, I just give each column dot size, column got printed, size got printed. Now I am telling, if there are totally 1 second, each number of rows where I have written that number of rows dot size, where is the list? Okay, now yes, yeah, now if you want to print the each column value, so total number of columns in particular row will be in this each column, right? So I am telling some 7 will be there, assume. So step by step I'll traverse. So I just used for loop. It's like again like I variable. I starts from the first column in first row, because this each column knows only information about the first row column, because the loop started for first time. So it took that go, this step says go and find the row, all the columns in the first row. Again it will come here, number of columns in the first row are these many, and now here only I am writing. So if there are these many columns, just traverse step by step on each column, okay, by keeping this variables like text. So I'll print this text dot get text. That means it will print the value present in that particular area. Okay, get text. So when you run this, you will see the page is loading. I think if this is loaded we can stop. Yeah, we can stop the loading. So value is getting printed, and yeah, oh, it's big. Look here, total rows are 17, columns in first row are 8, okay, columns in second row are 8, and see, these are the columns: Australian innings, R, M, B, 4S, 6s sr. If you go back and see, r m b 4s 6s sr. So all the text, the cell values are, we are able to grab the cell values by just giving getText method. Okay, so dot getText, you know, right? So by using that I grab each and every cell value in this table. So I'll tell you once again, the first foremost thing I have done is I took the table ID. In this table ID I told find elements with a tag name tr, so that I got some n number of rows, some these all rows I got. So next step what I have done is, for each row in for loop I traversed, so each row go and find elements with tag name td, so that I got all these columns with me. And if you want to see the text of that particular column, you know, just dot get text, then I am able to grab that text. Okay, this is called a multiple for loops, inner for loops. So this is the way. I'll send you the code, just try to analyze how did I use the rows, columns, and how did I grab the text present in the cells. So you got everything till the end. So not out 2 116, his score and everything we got here. This how we'll grab this text value, rows, columns, by using a tag names tr and td in WebDriver, right?